You know, it was very interesting because Ranveer and I are both with the same agency. When we're in the agency, he's obviously the senior star. But when we were on set, Sunil Gavaskar is the senior player compared to Kapil Dev. So it was, you know, sort of an inverse of what we are in real life. When you're opening for India and you're going to be the first person walking out from the pavilion onto the field and you've got the mighty West Indies who are all 6'2", you've got to project a certain confidence, a certain aura, and that's where the walk comes from. We've come away with lifelong friends. We've still got a WhatsApp group where all the 83 players are on. We've been in touch over the past 2 years. Even today, we're sharing what the responses we're getting on Instagram and Twitter. And on the contrary, like, we came away with a great bond. Hi, this is Tahir Raj Bhaseen and you're watching me on E-Times.
So, first of all, Tahir, welcome to E-Times. It's a pleasure talking to you. Congratulations for the rave reviews that 83 is getting. How are you feeling after all the positive response that has come your way?
Thanks so much for having me, Saloni. I am over the moon. I'm overwhelmed at the kind of love that it's getting from the critics, from the media, and most of all from the audience. You know, we waited 2 years for this film to come out. Doing this film was an emotional decision for me, purely because of the nostalgic value attached to the film and the fact that I was playing the living legend, Sunil Gavaskar. I've now watched the film 3 times in the theater, and every time it evokes the same emotion. I've got goosebumps, I've got tears, I'm laughing at the same time. And just to get similar responses on social media, on Instagram and Twitter, to have responses like, you know, my grandmother was a cricket fan and I took her to watch the film and she was in tears, or thank you for making my father relive his days in the 80s and recall a happy moment in the nation's history. I think we are all living through times when people want to watch something that makes them feel uplifted, and to, as an actor, to be a part of a journey that has allowed the audience that is incredibly rewarding.
You know, as you had earlier also mentioned that you and Ranveer both are playing very intricate characters of cricket legends, you being Sunil Gavaskar, playing Sunil Gavaskar, and him playing Kapil Dev. So how was it working out that kind of rapport on the sets, and how much of it resonated on screen as well?
You know, it was very interesting because Ranveer and I are both with the same agency. YRF handles both of us. So, you know, when the film was being prepped, we would meet each other often. When we're in the agency, he's obviously the senior star. But when we were on set, Sunil Gavaskar is the senior player compared to Kapil Dev. So it was, you know, sort of an inverse of what we are in real life. What was interesting was that there was definitely this undercurrent of a power dynamic going on between those two players. But I loved how subtly it was dealt. Like, that undercurrent was visible on screen, but it was very maturely handled. And it was done after a lot of conversations with Sunil Gavaskar, with Kapil Dev, with Kabir Khan. And the one particular scene that was that had me very anxious was the scene with Pankaj Tripathi, because that's a moment where you're seeing a player who has a burning need to perform for his country, and there's something that's keeping him from doing it. And you know, you want to say that without making him sound either aggressive or biased in any way. And I was so relieved when, after the film, Kabir told me that he really loved the performance. And one thing that they were all very clear about, Kabir Khan specifically, is that no matter what the dynamic was in the locker room, when we were on the field, you were focused on playing for India. Like, you know, then we were part of a team. And that's something that comes across really well in the film. One of my favorite moments in the film is when Kapil Dev scores the 175. They cut to a close of Sunil Gavaskar, and he's the first one to break into a big smile, take a glass of water, and run onto the field. And you know, there is no stereotypical conclusion to that power dynamic that happened in the scene. But just that one moment of him taking the glass of water and running onto the field with the rest of the team is closure to what had happened with the previous match. And that, for me, is really like a brilliant moment on film, because without words, you've communicated an emotion.
You know, so you work together with Sunil Gavaskar, you know, with real players. So any anecdotes that we don't know about, but that stayed with you, that happened during the shoots?
Yes, there was. You know, when I was offered the part to play Sunil Gavaskar, I got calls from different generations in my family to say that, are you going to get the walk right? And I had no idea what they meant because we've not grown up watching Sunil Gavaskar play. So I YouTubed a lot of his videos and I noticed that he had a definite strut to his walk. And it, I mean, today's generation would call it swag. And I realized that he was a style icon besides being a cricketer. Like back in the day, there were girls who would have posters of him in the room because of how stylish he was. And so I had to work a lot on that walk. And when I finally met him, I asked him, you know, what was there a conscious thought behind this walk, or is it just something that came to you naturally? And his answer was beautiful. He said that, you know, when you're opening for India and you're going to be the first person walking out from the pavilion onto the field, and you've got the mighty West Indies who are all 6'2", you've got to project a certain confidence, a certain aura. And that's where the walk comes from. And that conversation has stayed with me because I feel not only when you're playing Sunil Gavaskar, but even in life, when you walk into a room, how you carry yourself really says a lot about you.
You know, considering that 83 Stars, you know, one of the best talents in the industry right now, were you in any way apprehensive, you know, while taking up the role, be it the screen time or your character? Has that ever, you know, bothered you as an actor, as an individual actor?
No, not at all. I think like when you've got a master like Kabir Khan, you know, behind camera, it was very clear on paper that every actor and every sports legend would get their due and get their moment. The challenge for me in this film was matching up to the physicality of Sunil Gavaskar, being able to play a front cover drive like him, just being able to put your gloves on like him. Because if there's two things that this country loves, it's cricket and film. And when you're doing something that combines both of those, you know that you're going to be up for a lot of criticisms, a lot of comparison. So just to get that absolutely right was the thing that I was more concerned with. And it was actually exciting. It was motivating to know that the scene that I didn't know who the manager was, the actor who had been cast at the time that I signed on, because I think he came on after and I did. And so the next month when I found out that it's going to be Pankaj Tripathi, it was a relief because it'll uplift the scene when you've got him sitting opposite you. So for me, I really take like if I've got a star, a good actor in front of me, it's only going to up my game. So I was actually very confident about that.
So, you know, like there were so many actors on the set. So there can always be room for arguments or disagreements on how you project a scene, on how, you know, we go ahead with a certain thing. So if, or, you know, when such situations happen, how do you deal with them?
You know, I'm not saying this just because we're in an interview. Even if we were talking without the cameras, I would have given you the same answer. We were all just so excited to be on this. The only way to describe it is a trip, because, you know, which Indian boy doesn't want to put on the cricket kit and be at Lord's Stadium shooting for? So I think it was like those kind of arguments. Yes, if we were shooting, you know, in a remote part of the country where there was no electricity and there was heat and, you know, we were all under stress. But this was like you're going to your favorite destinations in the world. You're going to the Meccas of cricket. And you're getting to do what you love. So that just elevates everyone's mood. And today, 2 years on, when we look at it, if this film hadn't been shot back in 2018, I don't think in today's day it could have been made. So we're very fortunate to have been part of a time when, you know, travel restrictions and pandemics weren't, you know, even in people's vocabulary. So no, there was no. In fact, like, we've come away with lifelong friends. We've still got a WhatsApp group where all the 83 players are on. We've been in touch over the past 2 years. Even today, we're sharing what the responses we're getting on Instagram and Twitter. And on the contrary, like, we came away with a great bond.
That's great to hear. So coming to your next, that is Ye Kali Kali Aankhe, it's something entirely different that the audience is going to see you in. So could you tell us more about that character and how was it playing for that show, right? You know, in that show.
For sure. I mean, I'm really looking at 2022 as like a year of transition, Saloni, because I'm transitioning to main lead parts. And I've done some incredibly exciting stuff previously in playing an antagonist in Mardani and doing a college drama in Chichore and now a sports drama with 83. But doing a romantic lead, quote unquote, has its own sort of kick because you've grown up watching 90s Bollywood, you know, romantic heroes. And so I'm very excited because Ye Kali Kali Aankhe, as the title suggests, has a massive pulp Bollywood throwback to it. But it's also on Netflix and it's an OTT series. So it just gives you that much more time to live with the character, to explore a more broader story arc. And I'm just excited because the audience is going to get to see the soft romantic side transition into a dark thriller. And fingers crossed, because it's coming out the middle of Jan, and I'm excited to hear what people think about it.
And I mean, we must say that, as you mentioned, you have some quite different characters coming up. So, similarly with Ranjashi Sahi, you're going to go back to the Bollywood in the 70s. So how was it playing for that character, and how was it reliving the 70s, you know, in today's era?
That was, again, it was so challenging, because there are just certain things that we take for granted, either in our vocabulary or in our technology, that you just didn't have in the 70s. I'm playing a director back in 70s Bollywood. Mahesh Bhatt was the creative producer on that project. Just to have him on set and tell us how to do things was an incredible honor. And whenever you're doing a love story that involves Mahesh Bhatt, there's bound to be, he loves to challenge what it is that society does or does not accept, and play in that gray space when it comes to romance. Mm-hmm. And of course, the music. I can't wait for the music of the show to release, because it's the first time that I'm going to be doing scenes with which have this soulful romantic music to it, which always elevates what the audience feels. And so, again, over there, it's a sort of love triangle that I'm in. I just figured as I speak that it's also a love triangle in Ye Kali Kali Aankhein. So it's a sort of hat trick of romance as the year begins.
That's great. You know, one thing I've really noticed is with all your characters, there's always has been this gray shade. Like, in Mardani, it was an absolute antagonist. In Chichore also, we had a little bit of gray shade when you were playing the role. And even with Kali Kali Aankhein, it seems to be, you know, like a little bit of a gray shade. So what attracts you towards such characters, or, you know, what do you think of when you're signing your new projects?
For me, it's always interesting to play that gray shade, because I really believe that no one is all good and no one is all bad either. And it's a great time to be doing parts like that, because the audience is accepting of their lead hero to be flawed. And by flawed, I don't mean bad. I just mean that someone who could be, have a humanistic angle to them. So even in Mardani, if something bad happened to the antagonist, he broke down crying. And that's what made him human. And it's the same with Chichore, where he might have been the college stud, but he had a very soft spot for his college hostel boys. So to not make them a complete black or complete white, but to play somewhere in the middle is interesting as an actor. And it's great that the audience actually appreciates roles like that.
Coming back to your latest release, 83, there's like huge, like humongous response to the film, rave reviews, but the business has sort of been affected by the, you know, ongoing cases that are increasing cases of COVID in the country. So what do you have to say about, you know, whatever's happening with the kind of business side of the movie and the increasing cases that we are going to be seeing now, that we are seeing right now?
You know, I haven't once asked about the business side of things. For me, what we've really created, and this is based on the reviews that the media has been giving us, is really a timeless film. Whether you watch this film today or you watch it a few weeks from now when you're comfortable to go to the theater, or you watch it on OTT a few months from now, it's going to evoke the same emotion. Films like this are really made once in a lifetime. I got to hold the bat and walk out of the Lord's Pavilion as Sunil Gavaskar. And really, that is the biggest thrill for me. I'm also so excited that this film eventually did come out on the big screen, because that's the way it was meant to be enjoyed. And the people who have gone out and seen it have unanimously come out and said that we've loved it, like regardless of what age group you were with. The younger age group is thankful that they got to witness something that they had no idea about, and the older generation for its nostalgic value. So a film like really brings together generations and the country at a time when we need to feel uplifted. I'm incredibly proud of what we've achieved, and I'm very sure that even if in certain cities the theaters are shut, when they open, the film will still be there and the audience will be more than willing to go and check it out.
Thank you so much for talking to us. It was an amazing chat, and all the best for all your upcoming projects. We're looking forward to it.
Thank you. Look forward to chatting soon.